Naftoli Feldman lives in the Flatbush neighborhood of Brooklyn. In 1991, he found himself in the emergency room of a New York hospital.
I was having a heart attack at the time. There was a vessel that was blocked. Friday night, they put a team together, and they actually sent someone with a yarmulke to tell me that I must go through it even though it's Shabbos, because I had asked them. I was fine, I was stable, if I can wait till after Shabbos for them to do the procedure, and they sent someone with a yarmulke to tell me, no, this is okay. They unclogged me. Those days they used angioplasty. There was no stents at the time. And Shabbos morning, again, it collapsed. They redid it. And they told me that one of the problems is that I was clotting. I was clotting terribly. And they were giving me four times the amount of heparin, which is a blood thinner. And it just wasn't taking. Sunday morning, my wife went to the Rebbe to ask for a bracha.
My husband is a Mount Sinai with a heart condition. The name is Naftoli Elimelech and Esther Rachel.
She called me up. I told her it's not a problem. You know, please bring it in. But do not tell the Sefer that the Rebbe asked that the tefillin be baidik. Just bring it in, have them look at it. Sunday I developed a blood clot, Baruch Hashem, it went to my leg, not up. Monday morning they operated on my leg, they fished out the clot. They had given me a few transfusions, and they told me that it's just not helping. Tuesday at 3 o'clock, they have to take out all my blood and put back a transfusion, give me other blood. They don't see any other reason. They don't know why it's clotting, but it is clotting. This was Monday afternoon. Monday night at midnight, my wife gets a call from Rebbe Label Groner, and he says that Rebbe wants to know what is wrong with your husband's tefillin. This is midnight. She was petrified, and she said, "Tefillin are not back yet." He said, "The Rebbe's waiting for an answer. Here's my number. You'll call me back." There was no cell phones then. "You'll call me back as soon as you hear it. The Rebbe's waiting for an answer." That was his words. She called me in the morning, and she told me. I said, "Just call up the Sefer. Tell him that you need the tefillin back for your husband. Make up a story. Tell him that he's leaving. Anything you want, but don't tell him the Rebbe said so, but I need the tefillin back immediately." She called the Sefer 9, 10 o'clock. He says, "I understand. Your husband's tefillin are next. They will be checked. I will get back to you 12:30. He did get back at 12:30. Said the tefillin are 100% kosher. Just the tag from the lamed of Levavecha is missing. A tag you can fix. I fixed it. It's done. You can pick up your husband's tefillin anytime." They came in about 1:30 to take my blood again because they were going to take out all the blood, complete oil change. They came to take it. My blood was back to normal. They said it's impossible. They must have mixed up the blood because I've been clotting for the last 2 days, 3 days. They came again. They took blood again. Blood's back to normal. "Mr. Feldman, you can go home, except that I couldn't walk because of the surgery. So I had to stay in the hospital, not because of my blood." The blood was totally, totally back to normal. And I just, not Alzheimer's. How many people did the Rebbe see that day by dollars? On a normal Sunday, how many people did the Rebbe see? 1,000? 1,500? And how long was that conversation? Monday, with the Rebbe's schedule, to remember that Naftoli Feldman's in the hospital, to have someone call the house and say, what's wrong with his tefillin? To have someone that has no shaychus to Lubavitch at all, other than the fact that decided to come there one day, is, to me, remarkable.